In Datalore, you can easily create a new Jupyter notebook with Python, R, Scala, or Kotlin, or import an existing ipynb file, which is what I will do now. After importing the notebook, I click Run All to make sure that all cells run without any errors. To add a new cell, simply hover between the cells. You can add a bunch of cell types inside the notebook, including code and markdown, dropdowns, sliders, and charts, and you can even ask AI to help you with the next steps. You can use the editor's left-hand sidebar to get access to tabs for attached data, the environment, computation, the table of contents, and the variable viewer. You can also browse, search through, and open the notebooks you have in all available workspaces. I'll now quickly upload a CSV file to the notebook files. And ask AI assistant to read it with pandas. If you have worked with data frames, you'll be glad to hear that Datalore makes exploratory data analysis much easier. For each data frame, you get an interactive table output, where you can apply filtering and sorting. Scroll through all the values, remove duplicates, and quickly jump from top to bottom. On the Visualize tab, you are able to build quick visualizations and continue working with them either with Python code or in a dedicated chart cell. The Statistics tab gives you all of the necessary descriptive stats about the dataset, and you can easily see the column value distributions and figure out if there are any outliers. Data scientists tend to spend a lot of time cleaning up data and doing exploratory analysis. That's why we have integrated AI features to help you generate code with very little effort. Additionally, when writing Python, SQL, Scala, or R code, you have access to excellent code completion. For Python, you can also enjoy documentation pop-ups, quick fixes, and refactorings. To configure the look of the editor, you can go to the View menu tab and enable dark mode or turn on the split view. Inside the editor settings, you can turn on line numbers and documentation on hover, and you can change the font size. In the next video, we will explain how you can use Datalore to work with multiple data sources.